It's a journey of 40 years for me in this year. Never realized that I'll be a chef one day. Like any Punjabi families, you want to be a doctor or an engineer. If not, it's armed forces. And then our line was not treated so well when we joined the industry, unlike today. And we are glad that people have started recognizing our industry a bit more. They respect the chefs a little more with dignity. Still a long way to go, but I'm very sure the government of India will also help us in recognizing a lot of efforts which are being put by the chefs. Sometimes I wonder when people play two matches, they get the Padma Shris. When will the people get the Padma Shris who have spent their lives over here? It's really a challenge, but I'm sure one day, I'm sure this government of Dokhla.com will definitely get up and do it. For me, it's been an industry where I just wanted to be different from others. Everybody wants to be. And today's word is you have to be ahead of the competition. Not only in styling of food. Styling of food is one part of it. It is the taste buds. It's evolving. For the last two decades, we have seen a sea change in the food industry in India, and especially in the last 10 to 12 years. Like some gentleman said, restaurant is a very difficult business. It's not that easy to do a business in India. Sometimes it is the raw materials, sometimes it is the customer. You bring an authentic cuisine, Mexican cuisine to India, somebody says, oh no, that's not the way to do it. We want some more chatpata, so we want some more tikka. Then you literally get into the Gujarati Mexican food or Punjabi Mexican food, and everything comes into that. And I was surprised to see the chicken tikka makhni also being brought into the molecular. So it was very nice to see that how the industry is evolving today. Taj has always been, you know, I must share over here, we had the first 24 hours coffee shop in the country. 1972 was our first coffee shop in the country. 1973 was our first Golden Dragon Sichuan restaurant in the country. Otherwise, we had only Gobi Manchurian and Chicken Manchurian restaurants all the way. Then came the eras where the restaurants were dying, the French cuisine was dying, the classical cuisine was dying and giving way to the Nouvelle Cuisine. Nouvelle Cuisine, very short stint of life. Of course, it had to give way to the French chefs who were not willing to experiment too much within their own country. They got out of the country, they went to Europe, they went to Hong Kong, Singapore, started doing experiments and bringing new cuisines. Why I'm sharing with you is, West opened out, we did not. We as India, we did not. There were so many boundaries. North did not know anything about the southern cuisine. For them, South was idli, dosa, vada, sambar. That's it. Whereas those people in South, they knew it as chole bhature and butter chicken. East cuisine was hardly known. And then you come to the West. North Indians won't like the food which was a little sweet, which had coconut. So that was the end of regional cuisines. When we started doing the research work in late 70s or 80s, we realized what is the depth of the cuisine. You go to Kerala, Chettinad, the cuisine which is there is not even evolved. There are more than 25,000 recipes in our country, and we hardly know, not even 1,000. The time has come for life beyond tandoori chicken and biryani. So we have to move ahead. Indian cuisine has to be taken in a different form. Indian cuisine exported to the West, London having 9,800 Indian restaurants, so-called. 9,700 don't even serve good food. There might be counted few restaurants which serve, because they have made the food anglicized. They are very commercial in their way, because they want to make money. They have gone there to make money, so they make money. Whatever the Britishers want, they want to please them. I mean, if you eat a chicken tikka masala in that country, you will forget your own Ludhiana ka chicken tikka masala. That's the kind of food which has gone over there. So my request would be, those people who want to export the food, let it be in its own form. Let's take India. India is shining today. I think next 10 to 15 years belong to India again. And let's export the food in its right manner. Do the presentations well. Show the world what we are. We have all the skill. Our Indian chefs are amongst the best in the world. I can tell you that. They are the best. They are so hardworking. And they put in the number of hours. Is never a problem with our people. They don't work for 5 days a week like the West people do. And we start the food from scratch. Yes, there are some drawbacks we have for the raw materials. When we want to use the raw materials, the government doesn't allow us to import. I was told a few days back that fat duck liver and the goose liver has been banned. Come on, have a heart. 98% of the world is eating, and you want to ban one item which somebody doesn't like it somewhere. It's not fair. It's not fair for any Italian or French cuisine restaurant to deprive them of a raw material like this. It causes no harm. Let those people who want to enjoy the food, let them enjoy the food. For us, again, the buffets, the restaurant setting up, the trends. We took the leads in bringing wasabi on Indian scenario. It was a difficult task. It was a difficult task in the sense that importing of raw materials, one, costs are very high, two, then in Mumbai city, you are dealing with 45% of the vegetarian clientele. And there's hardly any vegetarian Japanese food. So we had to do the research work. We had to create that food for the vegetarians. Today, we can proudly say that 50% of our menus are vegetarian, equivalent to non-vegetarian food. That has been the success of Wasabi in Mumbai, and after 5 years, we opened the one in Delhi in Taj Mahal Singh. When we opened the masala brand, Masala Art in Delhi, it was a tough scenario. We wanted to change Haveli and Handi both. Difficult situation. Should Sikh kebab be there or not there? Should butter chicken be there or not there? We wanted to create a life beyond butter chicken and dal makhani. And everywhere we got a flak when we were making the menu. No, the restaurant will shut down if you don't have dal makhani, if you don't have butter chicken. My view was that if you have to open another butter chicken dal makhani restaurant, why to invest money? Let it run. Earlier also the restaurants were running. Do something different. Bring the food. We have a lot of food in our roots. Bring that food out. When we brought the food, I wanted to create a home atmosphere where fulkas were made in front of you. That was the first restaurant. We brought a fulka trolley where we wanted to create that at every home, I am sure, everybody wants to eat a hot chapati. And home away from home we created for people. When I was doing the research work of Atta Chicken about 17 years back, nobody knew the recipe of Atta Chicken in Punjab, except in Kotkapura, one city where one family knew about it. And mind it, this chicken is about 100 years old in our country. So we brought that Atta Chicken onto the menu. And when Atta Chicken came, in the last 10 years, every city in Punjab you go, original Atta Chicken banners have come over there. That is, I think, very good thing for all of us, chefs especially, to do little more R&D work and bring something different from our roots. Do the experiment, be experimentative, do the visually good food, make something different ahead of times, present the food well, do the fusions. The whole Europe is taking our ingredients. There's no harm in mixing of ingredients, but you must not forget your roots. You must know your basics well. Only then you can move ahead. You don't do your basics and the roots well, you, instead of fusion, you will cause a confusion all the way. Another thing I keep on telling the young chefs, from day one they start with it, no chef, this should be molecular, this should be that way. You know, we have to create, so-and-so chef has created molecular. They don't know how to cook the lamb rogan josh, but they want to do a molecular. Sometimes, you know, they keep on insisting. I tell them, no, first you learn the lamb rogan josh, you learn the chicken curry, learn the kormas, learn the biryanis, then do it. When they still don't listen, then I tell them, my dear, you were in liquid form when I was in uniform. For me, cook it, cook your food from the heart, serve with the warmth. That will be the essence of our industry. Rest of the things will follow. Don't run after money. Give the quality, money will run after you. And another thing is a curry in a hurry is my biggest worry. So let's not make the curries in a fly-by-night kind of curries. And I'm sure our industry will go ahead in a very different way. Thank you so much.